Green Bay is, in point of fact, one of the cradles of professional football. But more important for the modern day generation, it is the place where Vincent D. Lombardi gained renown as the finest of all contemporary football coaches. Even more, he was an extraordinary human being. We'd like to take you back in time. The year was 1964, the place, Sensenbrenner Hall, St. Norbert's College, as uniquely and exclusively, Mr. Lombardi allowed himself to be captured as he talked to his players for the initial session of that training campaign. So let's go back.
One thing about the Packers, it's a team with a great tradition, a great and a wonderful tradition. And that tradition, or that, whatever you want to call it, that glory that is the Packers has been developed through one thing only, and that's pride. Everybody has ability, but pride and performance is what makes the difference. Now, how do you develop pride? Pride is developed by tradition. That's how it's developed, by a winning tradition. Actually, the only difference between anyone in this league, any one person in this league, any player in the league, any team in the league, is in energy. This is a tough and it's a cruel business. We have to produce. We're only here because we win, period. And when we lose, we're gone. Therefore, we have to win. Therefore, you have to win. And we only want winners.
Vince Lombardi, born June 11, 1913. Principal occupation, football coach. Football really began for him at Fordham University as one of the immortal seven blocks of granite. He was taught to coach by his hero, Colonel Earl Red Blake of the United States Military Academy. His first big head coaching challenge, to revive the Green Bay Packers and to make a star of Paul Hornung. Lombardi told the Packers, football is two things. It's blocking and tackling. I don't care anything about formations or new offenses or tricks on defense. You block and tackle better than the team you're playing, you win. And when they did, in 61 and 62 against the New York Giants, the Green Bay helmet became a symbol of football supremacy. But 63 and 64 were lean years, and the depression of Paul Hornung shows it. Lombardi's indomitability brought them back. The indomitability together with the famed power sweep, Jerry Kramer's classic block for Bart Starr.
It was 15 below that bitter day. They called it the ice game. Don Meredith of Dallas would be the losing quarterback, but would be remembered always for the grace and the character he showed in defeat. It had all come down to just the one play. It had to be done. There was no more time. And so the discussion between Bart Starr and Vince Lombardi, the Dallas defense girding itself for the final action of the ball game. And there it was. And the Kramer block became history. And Vince Lombardi would win his second Super Bowl. And he would be known as the greatest football coach in the contemporary history of the game. There was the block again, number 64, on number 75, Jethro Pugh. And so, Green Bay remained not only one of the cradles of professional football, but the very center, the focus of the sport. What kind of man was Vince Lombardi?